Hello, welcome to the second episode of the CCR Liberty in Detail. In the previous episode, we were talking about where the Liberty Rebreathers are manufactured, the philosophy behind them, and we were having a look at the potential types of configurations that we can have. In this episode, we'll be talking about what is where on the individual units, and we will go through a quick description of the individual parts. So what we're gonna start with first is to have a look at the frame and what's built around it. So in this case of the back mounted unit, we've got a stainless steel frame or backplate, which can also be made out of titanium. And we've got our wing that's around it. The choice of the wing, it's up to you. You can go for various shapes. You can go for a horseshoe shape, or you can choose a donut. You can also go for the cool red color. And also you can choose your stand that you would like your unit to be fitted with. If you're a diver of a smaller posture, or you want something lighter, you would go for a small stand. If you would like something bigger, which would make your unit more stable, and also would give you the option of adding additional D-rings to it, you would go for the option with the white stand. Both those stands and the back plates can be made out of titanium to save some weights, depending on your preference of the type of diving you do. Now moving on to the side mount unit. The side mount unit is built around this frame. This is a frame made out of titanium. All the units come with a titanium frame that helps us to save weight of the unit, and the frame holds the unit nicely together. Next, moving back onto the back mounted unit, the other thing that we're going to look at now is our cylinders. The back mounted Liberty units come with 300 bar cylinders. The reason for that is that we can top those up to 300 bar, but also for a cave diving, this helps us to save lead weight having to put it anywhere else. So we've got the weight, we've got a little bit of extra weight in our cylinders, and that makes it nicely evenly distributed along our back. If you still do need additional weight, your back mounted unit will come with dumpable weight pouches, which we're going to demonstrate now. Next thing, we're moving onto our head. Our head is here, and our head houses all the crucial parts of the system. All the electronic parts, all our control units, all that kind of equipment. The head has head-up display. We have a body display here, and every unit comes with two handsets. In our next episode, we're going to be talking about our head in more detail. Below our head, we have our scrubber canister. On the side mount, the scrubber canister is here. You can see the difference between these two. These are actually both 2.5 kilo scrubbers. We also have a 3.3 kilo scrubber. The scrubber we're using is a radial type scrubber, and we're gonna have a whole episode where we're gonna look more into the detail of how to pack the scrubber and how the scrubber works. The next thing we're looking at is our loop. So the direction of the breathing is this way, from left to right. So we're inhaling the gas that's coming out of the head. In this case, our ADV is here. You can also have an ADV in your BOV. So in this case, the ADV would not be here, but it would be just here in the BOV. Inside of our BOV and our DSV, we have mushroom valves, which are one directional valves. They direct our gas in one direction and stop it from moving in the other direction. Inside of the BOV, it looks like this. The mushroom valves just sit one here, the other one sits here, and they direct the gas flow in one direction. The back mounted unit can be either fitted with BOV or it can be fitted with DSV. The side mounted unit is fitted just with the DSV. All the BOVs or DSVs can be fitted with manual addition valves, which are located here near your mouth. So the idea behind having our manual addition valves here is that when you're in the right trim, your arms are mostly in front of you. So when you can find your mouth, you can find your manual addition valves. On the side mounted unit, your mouths are located here, again, close to your mouth, where they're easy to be found. On the front mounted counterlung configuration, the manual addition valves are located here on the front of your counterlungs. The oxygen manual addition valve, MAV, is located on exhaling side. So when we inject the oxygen, it's gonna go first through the scrubber and the system for you to be able to rebreathe it, which is another safety feature of the unit. When it comes to ADV options, you have a variety to choose from too. So in the back mounted counterlung version, you have two options. You can either go for T-piece ADV, which is located on your shoulder, or you can go for a version of an ADV which is located in your BOV. So it's here. We're gonna have a look more into detail of this later. On the side mount unit, your membrane ADV is located here. On the front mounted counterlung unit, you have a more of a variety too. So you can either go for BOV with ADV, or you can go for standard ADV, which is here, or you can go for membrane ADV, which is this one. Okay, so the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to remove our loop now. All the connections to our counterlungs and to the head are through bayonet connections. So all you need is half a turn to get things on and off. So I'm gonna take the loop off now. So I'm gonna start off with the head. So I'm going to move this hose out of the way and I'm going to twist this here. We have markings here that we gotta line up and we just pulled this part out. Now we're gonna twist the other way and pull up again and we're disconnected. Each elbow has a different number of locks, so they cannot be exchanged. The same way applies to our counterlungs. Everything is clearly marked. All you gotta do is you just gotta line up the markers. So you twist halfway, disconnect. Twist halfway here, disconnect. We're off, and we've got our loop off, or we put the loop back on the same way. Now we're ready to clean our loop or put it back on when we need to assemble our unit during our pre-dive checklist. Now that we have removed the loop, we can clearly see our counterlungs. As you can see in this configuration, this is the back mounted counterlung version. So the counterlungs start on the shoulders and they basically go back down. On the front mounted counterlung version, you can see that the counterlungs sit on the front of your chest. Our back mounted counterlungs as well as our front mounted counterlungs are removable. So the way to remove them is you just undo it here. We've got a zipper here that we are going to undo now. Unzip this up, take off. And now we can go and clean our counterlungs or do whatever we need to do with them. The next thing that we're going to do is that we're going to remove our head and our scrubber canister off the frame. The head and the scrubber canister is held by this lock and by the strap here. The lock is the main part that holds the head and the scrubber canister to the frame. The reason behind the locking system being here that under any circumstances, we do not want our head and a scrubber canister to open underwater. So you have to take the unit off your back for you to be able to remove the head and the scrubber canister. So now I'm gonna show you how I remove the head with the scrubber canister. First of all, you undo the strap here. This frees this part up. Grab onto the lock, lift it open, detach the head, with a scrubber, place it here. I'll light this down. Move that out of the way so we've got a bit more of a room. And what you do now to get inside of the head or a scrubber is that you place the part of the unit on the flat surface, push down on it. This will separate. And this way we've got access to our head and to our scrubber canister. So this is it for the second episode. In the next episode, we're gonna be looking at the Liberty head in the detail. For more information, please visit our webpage, divesoft.com, where you can find all the information and our configurator, where you can configure the unit of your desired configuration. And if you've got any further questions, please email us at info@divesoft.com. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to seeing you next time.